sticks.
Interesting. Load the bomb. Or pick the bomb up. Or
okay. Right, origins and history. I'm very interested now.
Written in the Forest of Dean by your uncle. That's what the article will say. Not specifically yours. No. It'll just say, written in the Forest of Dean by your uncle.
Yeah.
Because that could refer to anyone we know.
The term Taffy may be a merging of the common Welsh name Dafydd and the Welsh river Taff, on which Cardiff is built, and seems to have been in use by the mid-18th century. The rhyme may be related to one published in Tommy Thumb's Pretty Songbook, printed in London around 1744, which had the lyrics, Taffy was born on a moonshiny night, his head in a pipkin, his heels upright.
I'm learning. It's great.
The earliest record we have of the better-known rhyme is from Nancy... Okay, it does say that. Nancy Cox's Pretty Songbook, printed in London around 1780, which had one verse. Taffy was a Welshman, Taffy was a thief. Taffy came to my house and stole a piece of beef. I went to Taffy's house, Taffy wasn't home. Taffy came to my house and stole a marrow bone. Similar versions were printed in collections in the late 18th century. However, in Songs for the Nursery, printed in 1805, the first signs of violence were evident, ending with, I went to Taffy's house, Taffy was in bed. Fuck. I took the marrow bone and beat about his head. In the 1840s, James Orr... I'm just reading this. In the 1840s, do you want me to just carry on?
Yeah, no, I'm intrigued. Like, right, I'm learning, if no one else is.
What the fuck is happening, though?
I'm just... in the game. I'm trying to figure out if these are bombs, and oh, fucking hell, these aren't even the bombs, are they? I just remember what the bombs were.
In the 1840s, James Orchard Halliwell collects the two-verse version that followed this with, I went to Taffy's house, Taffy was not in. Taffy came to my house and stole a silver pin. I went to Taffy's house, Taffy was in bed. I took up a poker and threw it at his head. This version seems to have been very... been particularly popular in the English counties that bordered Wales,
where it was
sung on St. David's Day, complete with the leek-wearing effigies of Welshmen. The image of thieving Welshmen seems to have begun to die down by the mid-20th century.
Yeah, when they stopped stealing our shit.
Although the insulting rhyme was still sometimes used along with the name Taffy for any Welshman. Fucking hell.
Oh, that's the fucking best. I love it. I love it. I'm sorry. I know it's racist. I know it's ass backwards in terms of progression, but we were raised in a very racist place. It's the kind of thing that we live with every day. I'm sure we've said this before. And it does make me laugh to think that's how we were and how we were raised. And I worked with a dude from... Wales who called himself Taffy, and it's very sad that he's no longer with us. I mean, he's alive, he's not dead, but he's no longer working with us. And so I have to just sort of impart all these weird Welsh racist quirks on the other guy who's there. And I'm gonna memorize that poem, and on Monday I'm gonna find him and I'm gonna follow him around all day and just be like, Taffy was a Welshman, I beat him about the head. Oh, that was great. I love it. I fucking love it. Your interest in my racism has revitalized me.
Okay. Oh, fuck. There's a lot of them.
They are slightly more numerous. And also, I'm slowly sliding down this thing. You... fuck off, and you also doubly fuck off.
Oh, dude, they got her.
I know they got her. But I got them. God Christ, no, fuck. Okay, yeah, whatever. Get up, please. Nope. I wish there was some sort of warning that was actually happening. Oh, fuck you. Okay, they can interrupt me. Get up, please. Oh, it's good. They picked her back up and
And they're going over the other side.
That's fine. That's fine. They're down. For now. There you are. I don't think so.
Asshole.
I don't fucking think so. Shadow beasts.
Be gone, wicked spawn of Satan! They ain't dead yet.
No, there's bound to be another one somewhere. The portal is still there.
It's bound there. Ah! Oh, fuck you. Fuck. Fuck.
Thought you could sneak up on me, huh? I've got a stick. You haven't. Therefore.
Just because you are creatures of some form of shadow realm and have the ability to knock me unconscious, you think you can beat me and my stick?
So far, evidence has proven the contrary.
Ha! So go fuck yourself, weird things.
How are those wings even working? They have no webbing, they have no membranes. Okay, whatever. Your wings make more sense, but... But your existence is null. Eat stick, Shadow Boy!
Oh, he's dead.
Come on.
Come on. Come on. You big chicken.
It seems to be. Is that it? Music seems to have stopped. Yep.
Are we done?
Yes. Yeah, we're done. Now we can go and open this door. Do the magic shiny thing. Do the magic shiny thing. Oh, I need to be holding her hand.
Awkward.
Our magic powers only work when you're holding hands. Actually, that's kind of sweet. Let me use that somehow. What?
Nothing.
No bombs. Yeah, bombs.
Run away from the bomb.
It's over here.
Nothing.
Door. I'm guessing we gotta blow that up.
Oh,
oh, really?
Fuck!
Fuck you, come on. You just got outside.
Where's their base? Where's the portal?
Very good question. Oh, it's
there
all
it is.
The way over there. All the way over. Okay, there's one there too. But where have they taken her? Shit. Shit, this place is big. This place is big.
There
this
it is.
This place is big. And this is as fast as I run. It feels quite fast when you're doing non- combat-y things, but suddenly when you're in a big area like this, it does not feel bad enough. Let's get you away. Get off. Go away. My girl. Mine. There's a weird sense of, like prehistoric ownership going on right now, which is a little bit uncomfortable, but I got a stick, so that's cool. I feel noble. And sometimes that's all that matters. That sounds like a very horrible excuse. Perspective is being weird again. Can't tell where they are. So it seems like I don't have a health bar or anything. I mean, I can't see one, but it seems like the knocking down constantly is not actually adversely affecting me, which is ideal, really. Come on. Come get some. No! I was joking when I said come get some.
I didn't think you'd actually take me up on my offer.
It's time for an ass whooping.
According to psychologists, exposure to nature allows us to remember and value important things like relationships, sharing, and community.
Yes, but why?
It's what the fuck facts.
Video, what the fuck, that's just a fact.
Ostrich's eyeball is bigger than its head, brain.
Try that sentence again. An ostrich's eyeball is bigger than its head.
An ostrich's eye is bigger than its brain.
Yes, that much I know. The head thing doesn't make any sense. Unless you're talking about some sort of eldritch horror. Which I have been reading a lot of lately. I'm currently splitting my reading time between another collection of H.P. Lovecraft stories, and Norwegian Wood by Haruki Murakami, which is intriguing. I love Haruki Murakami, he's amazing. He writes books how I want to write books. No! Get up! They're taking your girl. Where? Okay. Nope, not today. Come on. Oh, fuck.
You are no longer my friend or my fellow DJ.
I don't know why I was thinking about that film earlier today, but I just was, so. I'm still trying to remember what the song was that I was singing.
All I wanna do is do it.
Not that one, no.
Bingo.
But that one did come into my mind. Shit, what was it I was singing all day? Now is really not the time to be concentrating this hard on a song. There we go. That's useful. Holding R1 allows me to find out where she is. Fuck off!
At least she's out.
Yes. Time on the floor again. Oh, I remember now. I once knew a kid, his tongue fell off in his sleep. The bibbidi bibbidum, the bibbidi bibbidoo. The girl in my basement probably thinks I'm a creep. The bibbidi bibbidum, the bibbidi bibbidoo. I've got 12 cases of herbal fungal ointment that nobody can use without appointment down in Woodbury, where it's very the bibbidi bibbidum, the bibbidi bibbidum. Give me some bubble gum. Do you know that song?
No. You listen to some fucked up music.
My uncle was tall but had these really short legs.
Why are you so pale?
La bibbidi bibbidum, la bibbidi bibbidoo. Do you think poodles in Jamaica has dreads? La bibbidi bibbidum. It could be because that might be a measurement of my health, possibly.
Possibly.
Which doesn't bode well because he seems to be. This feels like it's taking quite a long time. I'm not liking the slow pace of it. Heads in aquariums. I like heads in aquariums. I don't find them scary. I'm fond of Bavarian cream. I dream of the bibbidi bibbidi dum. The bibbidi bibbidi dee. The bibbidi bibbidi dum. Dum 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 dum. Sorry, I'm sure that's very annoying for many people considering how badly I sing.
La 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 la.
Come on, I'm just trying to get myself through this moment. And also remember the rest.
Starfish Command. Star trekking across the universe.
That song was in my head last week. Mostly because I really enjoyed the "It's worse than that, he's dead, Jim, dead, Jim, dead, Jim, it's worse than that, he's dead, Jim, dead, Jim, dead."
It's life, Jim, but not as we know it, not as we know it, not as we know it. It's life, Jim, but not as we know it, not as we know it, Captain.
There's Klingons on the starboard bow, starboard bow, starboard bow. There's Klingons on the starboard bow, starboard bow, Jim.
Star trekking across the universe
on the Starship Enterprise under Captain Kirk.
Star trekking across the universe,
only going forward because we can't find reverse.
We're so cool.
Yeah, we are. What are the other ones? You cannot change the laws of physics, laws of physics, laws of physics. You cannot change the laws of physics, Jim. It's worse than that, he's dead, Jim, dead, Jim, dead, Jim. It's worse than that, he's dead, Jim, dead, Jim, dead. This is still not over.
No, it isn't.
I don't even know what else is in this room right now, to be honest. I don't know why we're here beyond just dealing with this bullshit. Still, it's given us plenty of time to bond over songs.
It has.
I bet the shadow creatures would appreciate our singing. They look like the kind of guys who would appreciate our singing. Come on, just do something already.
I'm gonna get you. Oh no, I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna get you.
The problem is, when he jumps back, I can't hit him. So it's like, it's a stalemate for all involved. Because he's not getting closer to his goal, and I'm not getting closer to killing him. Maybe I should check.
Oh shit.
One time he decides to actually do a proper full combo, and it's like, in the wrong direction, away from him, while he's grabbing something else. I'm gonna check the controls and see if it's like the lock-on option or something, because. Hold, call, zoom, action. Nope, there is not. Okay. Just carry on as we are then.
Have you ever watched Anastasia?
Yes.
What do you think of it?
I enjoy it largely because of that one song in The Dark of the Night. And because Christopher Lloyd is cool. But I do remember I had a friend in college who was an enormous fan of the whole Romanikov, I think it is, the Romanikov family line. And I remember she absolutely hated that movie on account of how badly it butchers the whole thing, because of course it's not even remotely accurate. Romanov family. Why?
Because I watched it on Netflix not so long ago, and like,
yeah, I also watched it on Netflix, but a while ago. Is it over? Please continue your Anastasia story. Yes, it is. Finally, now let's figure out what this room's all about.
Yeah, I just thought you know it was one that I'd never watched before, and
okay, graves or beds?
Hopefully not beds. They don't look very comfortable.
There's a lot of weirdness in this world, so I wouldn't be surprised if they were beds. I mean, those benches are just solid stone, so. Oh, so this place was just one big arena. Doesn't seem like there's actually anything else in here besides that door. But we're gonna have a look around anyway. Actually, I'm gonna leave you over by the door. Because I imagine I'm gonna just see nothing here.
Yeah, I watched it and I thought, I fell in love with Pooka straight away. Yeah, the dog. Didn't realise until the very end that it was, Kelsey Grammer.
Really?
Who plays Dimitri's mate, the big guy. Black hair, the glasses.
Oh, cool, I didn't even know that. I like Kelsey Grammer.
Where'd she go?
She went that away.
Why?
She was exploring like I was, which is kind of cool, I suppose. Yeah, I can say this because I know that the video is going to go up significantly after it, but did I tell you what my sister asked for her birthday? Complete Frasier box set.
Cool!
Because, like, we used to watch that show all the time. I fucking love it. And I really enjoy Kelsey Grammer as a actor. That's why I follow him on Twitter, because he's occasionally quite funny on there. Ooh, cutscene. Look, the gate is open. Now we can get out of here. Well, that definitely doesn't seem like the full game, so I doubt we're going to get out of here. Yeah, the gate is no longer open.
You ain't gonna make it.
We've already seen how slow your running is based on that last battle arena, so.
Oh, you stupid.
Huh.
That doesn't look good.
This looks like
bots.
Oh. Oh. Okay.
Just runs out with a stick.
Yorda. Her name is Yorda, assuming. Well, no, because she speaks that weird squiggly language. The girl you're with is my one and only beloved girl. I'm wasting my time. She was just helping me leave. Some boy with horns. Well, maybe, but she can open the doors I need to open to get out of here. Know your place and leave here. Well, that's kind of what I'm trying to do.
Yeah. Kind of need Yorda's help. Need Yorda's help? I didn't know. Sorry, that was too easy.
Let's not.
That was too easy.
Well, okay. All of that about don't go near my daughter and she doesn't even do it.
Yeah, anymore. She just takes it back. She just goes away.
Was a thing that happened.
Yeah.
Interesting.
There's a save point to
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I know. I noticed. My eye is good at scoping out such things. Come sit by me on the stone bench. Saving the game. So it would seem that her name is Yorda, and I'm guessing we're trying to save her from her mother, who is a Shadow Lady.
But if that were the case, why didn't the mother, who is quite clearly infinitely more powerful than us, just take her back?
That's what I was wondering. But, you know, I guess these are mysteries that we will learn at a later date during this time.
At a later date during this time?
Yeah.
Don't want to be any more contradictory with yourself there?
No, I think it makes perfect sense.
Okay.
During our time together with this game, we will eventually figure this stuff out as they progress as part of the story. See, he's excited. I'm going on an adventure with a crazy girl I can't understand.
I'm going
saving
to Disneyland.
Her from
Mum. I'm going to Disneyland.
No, I'm really not going to Disneyland.
I've never been to Disneyland.
I've been to two Disneylands.
Have you been to Florida?
Yes, Florida.
Florida.
Florida and Paris.
Oh, you've been to Paris?
Yeah.
Or Euro Disney, as it was once called.
Yeah, I went there just after it opened. So I don't remember it.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, it's an hour and a half, so.
Really? It's been.
Yeah,
holy
that was
shit.
That was perfectly timed, really. I mean.
Holy shit. So, we figured out that we don't have a name. Those
I believe
horns,
his name is Arco. Eco.
That, not confirmed.
Not confirmed, but I believe it.
That helmet is his head.
It's not a helmet, it's just his head. And he's wearing a bandana.
Sticks are super effective against shadow creatures.
Generally.
Who knew?
But they are avoidative as crazy. As crazy. That was not even a sentence.
As crazy. Her
as
name
balls.
Is Yorda.
And she has a mum.
And she has a mum.
And she doesn't exist in
our world.
Pretty
dead set about us, like, hanging out with her.
Yeah, but doesn't seem to want to actually do anything about it right
no,
now.
No, not right now. And we're outside in the sunshine.
By the gate that we can't open.
By the gate that we can't open. It's a pretty full day. And yeah, that's where we are.
Where'd you go? Bird.
Bird!
I'm gonna go chase the bird.
You're gonna go chase the bird?
I'm gonna go chase the bird.
Right.
Where do we go? I'm chasing the bird.
Stop.
I was running into a pillar.
You were. Stop
chasing
the bird.
I'm chasing the bird. Oh, wait a second. Yes.
Ooh. Oh.
I'm not gonna do that because I'll say that for next time.
For next time.
Next time on this adventure in this place with the crazy Yorda.
See you next time, everybody.
You probably will. Unless nothing happens.
Well, something will happen.
Something always happens.
Something always happens.
Happening is a happening.
Anyway.
Yeah.
I'm going to outro because I feel I'm in an outro place now.
We are. Well, I thought we already did outro.
Well,
but go ahead and outro.
Thank you very much.
Outro to your heart.
Thank you, I shall.
Get to the outro.
This has been like...
Why aren't you outroing? Start outroing, please. You said you were going to outro, and yet we're not outroing. Why aren't you outroing?
Will you let me?
No.
No? You won't let me outro?
Only when you outro.
What? You're not letting me outro.
Then start outroing.
Right. This has been like...
You need to outro.
This has
if
been
we don't
Ico.
Outro, then how was this win?
Fuck it.
Yeah.
This has been Ico. I've been Osana. He's been the very irritating Finch in these last 2 minutes.
Yeah, this rock star has kind of gone down pretty well.
I could do with a rock star.
I do have another one in the fridge if you want.
Oh, do you mind?
Well, that's why I offered it to you.
Sweet. Right. Rock star up. And we will see you guys again soon.
Yeah.
Well, we won't see you. We don't have face cam.
Well, we wouldn't be able to see them if we did, because that's not how cameras work.
Then you will hear us. soon.
And you will see our shenanigans on screen, and we're still pointing at the microphone.
Yeah, why are we still pointing at the microphone?
Because like that is our person? Source.
This is quite possibly the longest outro.
What?
This is quite possibly the longest outro. Bye.
Bye.
Taffs.
Taffy was a wedge.
And I'm not having Dax to be the fucking third wheel.
Well, Dax is not involved.